Okay, hello everyone. I'm Futoshi Tani. I'm very honored to talk about my recent work about variational inference based on robust divergences. In this research, we focus on ultra-high robust inference. So let us start from what is ultra-high robust inference. The definition of ultra-high is difficult in general, but in this slide, we simply consider that ultra-high are the data which is not the main body of the data. This conceptual figure illustrates the empirical distribution or histogram. And outlier is expressed as the data which is far away from main body of data. Also, we can regard the outlier as the contamination to the main body of the data. And in outlier robust inference, we would like to disregard such an outlier data point automatically. More formally, we consider a situation that independent samples x1 to n are generated from some unknown distribution p star x, and p star x is consisted from two parts. One is main body of data, and the other is the contamination. And in ultra-high robust inference, we want to place in the estimated probability distribution close to the main body of the unknown distribution. To estimate the unknown distribution, most simple method is the maximum likelihood estimation. To this end, we consider the parametric model Px theta, and we measure the generalization error by k of divergence from p star x to px theta. And p star x is unknown, so we will approximate it by empirical distribution. And by minimizing the k of divergence with respect to theta, we obtain this estimator. Actually, maximum likelihood estimation is sensitive to outliers because it treats all data points equally. To avoid such a problem, robust divergence was developed. One is called beta divergence or density power divergence, which is developed about 20 years ago. And another one is called gamma divergence, which is defined in this way. And based on these divergences, in robust divergence minimization framework, we measure the generalization error, not k divergence, but beta or gamma divergence. Here, I pick up the beta divergence, for example. We measure the generalization error p hat x to px theta, and we will minimize it with respect to theta, and we obtain this kind of estimator. And the second part is the for unbiasedness, so it is not so important. And what is important here is the first term. Compared to the maximum likelihood estimator, there appears a new coefficient here. This is called density power weights. Actually, this likelihood is weighted according to the power of the probability for each data point. And in outlier robust inference, we want to model the distribution of the main body of data, and we assume that the probability of outliers are much smaller than compared to the main body of data. So, these weights effectively suppress the likelihood of outliers. And when beta equals zero, all weights become one, and this estimator is reduced to usual maximum likelihood estimation. So, this parameter beta controls the trade-off between robustness and efficiency. Until now, we consider the parameter as not a random variable. And in Bayesian framework, theta is a random variable and follows some probability distribution. Here, we denote the prior distribution as p theta, and we update this prior distribution by using Bayes theorem, and we obtain the Bayesian posterior. And actually, there are another way to obtain the Bayesian posterior. In that method, we solve the optimization problem in this way. And here, q theta is the solution of this optimization problem, and p is the set of all probability distribution. And the objective function of this optimization problem is written in this way. The first term is k divergence q theta to prior, and second term is the expected cross entropy. And solving this optimization problem by variation method, we obtain this kind of expression. And substituting the definition of process entropy, we obtain this kind of expression. Actually, this is equivalent to the distribution which is derived by Bayes' theorem. Actually, analytical expression of this distribution is intractable. So we have to use some approximation method. One common method is the descriptive domain of the optimization problem to analytically solvable some distributions. Here, those distributions are parameterized by M. Now what we solve is this optimization problem. And this method is called variation inference. And minus L is often called evidence lower bound. This is a summary up to now. In non-Bayesian method, there exists a general robustifying method that is, we minimize the generalization error, not Kerr divergence, but robust divergence. The benefit of this kind of method is we don't have to change the parametric model to enhance the robustness. Therefore, this robust divergence minimization framework also seems very promising to enhance the robustness in the Bayesian framework. So we consider how to incorporate the robust divergence property in Bayesian framework. So to solve this, what we focus on is the transformation of the objective function of Bayesian inference. This objective function can be transformed into this way. The meaning of this expression is that the first term is the expected generalization error, pista x to px theta, and second term is the regularization term, which regularizes q theta to the prior p theta. And in this expression, the term where the training data appears is the first term. So to enhance the robustness, we simply consider to replace the KL divergence to robust divergence. Here, we pick up the example of beta divergence. And back to the closed entropy formulation, what we solve is this optimization problem. And this d beta is the beta closed entropy, which is defined in this way. Actually, we can solve this by variation method and obtain this kind of posterior. And this is the kind of pseudo posterior or Gibbs posterior. And in this expression, contrary to relation is broken, so analytical solution is interruptible. And in the same line with the Bayesian inference, we restrict the domain of optimization problem in this way. And now what we solve is this optimization problem. And since we used beta divergence here, so we name it beta variation inference, or beta VI. This is the summary up to now. Now, what we solve is this optimization problem, which includes the robust divergence for the data fitting term. And this is the kind of pseudo Bayesian method. Next, we investigate the robustness of our proposing method by using the inference function. Actually, inference function represents the relative bias of the estimated study caused by actual errors. This is the definition of inference function, where gx is the empirical distribution, and g epsilon zx is the contaminated version of the empirical distribution, where the contamination appears at the point z with the proportion epsilon. And here we express this study by t, and by tgx, we denote the study which is derived by the empirical distribution gx. Actually, in our work, we use the inference function in two ways. First, we investigate the supremum of the inference function with respect to the contamination point. Because if the inference function diverges, the model can be sensitive to small contamination of data, so the model is not robust. And Second, we investigate how the predictive distribution is affected by actual errors. Invasion inference, what we really want to know is the predictive distribution. So investigating these kind of quantities is very important. And by using the chain rule, we can obtain this kind of expression where the inference function appears here. Let's back to the variation inference. And in variation inference, the static t in the definition of inference function is correspond to the variation parameter m. So based on that fact, actually we can derive the inference function of variation inference in this way. This expression is a little complicated, so I will skip its meaning. But anyway, based on this expression, we can analyze the inference function of a proposing method. Here we look at the behavior of supremum of the inference function. Since the general inference function analysis is very difficult, we focus on some specific models. Here we picked up the Bayesian neural networks for regression, logistic regression problem. And analysis is a bit complicated, but the message here is that the inference function of usual variational inference method is not always bounded, especially when using relative activation function, inference function can be diverged. But we found that ours is always bounded. We also confirmed the usefulness of our proposing method on the some usual dataset. We used the Bayesian neural network with two hidden layers and each with 20 units and relative activation function. And actually, we choose the parameter beta or gamma by cross validation from the range of 0.1 to 0.9. And this is only the result of regression. We found that actually gamma divergence case is most promising. For experimental detail, please check out paper. This is the conclusion. We propose the outright but pseudo-Bayesian variation inference method by replacing the KL divergence used for data fitting term to robust divergence. And we analyze the our proposing method by using the inference function analytically and dynamically. And we confirm the usefulness of our proposing method on the usual dataset by using Bayesian neural nets. That's all for my talk. Thank you for listening.